Yo, 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 it's Mac Praise.
Yeah, and your boy, the man, his name.
Listen, my colleague, my partner, my brother came up with a topic that we want to talk about today. We were just talking about the series Chosen, which me personally, I have never seen. I heard a lot of people talking about it. Have you seen
it? Yeah, I watched it.
You watched the whole thing?
I don't know. I watched 8 episodes.
Hey, how many episodes are there?
I don't know. They stopped having more episodes after that.
So today we're going to talk about down-to-earth Jesus.
Yes, indeed.
So, I'm going to ask you something, Brother Payne.
Mm-hmm.
All right. We look at the scriptures in the Bible.
Yeah.
And you know, and one thing you just said, what you liked about the series Chosen, that it made Jesus, you know, like one of us.
Right.
You know,
right,
they
right,
filled in the blanks. You even told me, you said, like on certain situations, Jesus would look at folks like, what'd you say? Like, man, you crazy. Like, yeah, why'd you like do that? You know, like.
It don't make sense.
It don't make no sense. So, man, please explain to me, like, growing up reading the Bible, how did the Bible make you think about Jesus? Like,
Not just Jesus, but God, the whole religion type deal.
Yeah.
I was like, man, it was something I felt like I was forced to partake. Oh, I say it this way.
See,
it made me feel like I have to do this.
Right.
I have, like, everything got to be this boring way. And that's really what it is.
Right.
Like, when you come to Christ, because you see people in church, they always serious.
I ain't lying.
They always, you shall not do that. Man, you live in the 2000s. Stop talking like that. Like, be for real. You know what I'm saying?
And
like, me and brother same way, like, we people that love to laugh and have fun. We talk about each other all the time. I remember we were riding a couple of weeks ago, and I said, man, I had said something crazy to him. I was talking about him. And I said, man, I apologize. I don't know why I talk to you like that, man. I apologize. Like, man, that's how we talk to each other. I know not to take you serious. You ain't up, you know what I'm saying? He said, you ain't nobody or something like that. He said, just something like,
nah, I don't even say that. I'm really saying that.
But anyway, like, that's how we socialize with one another. But being a Christian don't mean you can't talk and have fun like that.
Mm. You know, we made the other one called Bored Christian. Mm-hmm. But this time we're talking about how down to earth that the Lord really was.
Mm-hmm. Down to earth Jesus.
I'm gonna put it like this. Hallelujah. You see my personality. You see homie personality. Where did we get our personalities from in the first place?
Mm.
You understand? So when we look at this, how can Mac be all like that? And he ain't on crack.
You being extra right now.
Yeah. But how can I be like this? Joking, laughing, whatnot. But I didn't even create myself to be this.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't make myself to be like this. There must be a higher person, creator, that put this in me. So if this person, which we know to be our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, God Almighty, if he had the heart to put in the heart, put this in me, put this in my characteristic, make this my characteristic, then how funny, goofy, silly, upright, understanding, loving, compassionate, is him. You feel me?
You know, and basically what you're getting down to is the fact that, like, he created us in his image.
In his image.
So, God has to have a sense of humor.
Has to.
Because if not, then, oh my goodness, we in trouble.
We are.
We in trouble.
Because why we acting like this?
I'm just talking about mankind in general. I ain't just talking about us. But then what I'm saying, like, if God doesn't have a sense of humor, what's the point of laughter? We wouldn't have no laughter. Like, if God doesn't have a sense of humor, then being happy would be a sin.
That's what I meant.
Smiling would be a sin, but you didn't say it. I did.
Well, you're right.
He just heard me say something dope and be like, yeah, I said that first.
No, but that's what I was talking about. What we doing then? That's what I meant.
Exactly.
What we doing? You know? Listen, I mean, cut you off.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm going to say this, though.
Yeah.
Jesus, the thing, I've been on YouTube 2-3 years now, and this is one thing that I've said. I used to tell folks, why everybody so strong faced and I got this today. I said, why the people that the ministers that I see that don't never smile, they don't never laugh, they ain't never joking, why they got a lot of followers? Why they got a lot of listeners? You know why? This the Holy Spirit told me this today. See, y'all take the person that don't smile and don't laugh more serious because you think that person ain't going to lead you astray. Or if he joking and laughing, he ain't right. Something ain't right.
Okay. So.
You feel what I'm saying?
So, because he's so serious all the time.
Right.
He's serious about
he
God.
He said, what?
Listen.
Down some water on me. Listen.
You don't want people to see that.
Man, listen. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
Since his attitude is more serious.
Yeah. Well, he must be serious about the Lord. And plus, not only that, but that's what people used to anyway.
That's what a lot of folks
so used that's to. That's why they're so quick to draw to it because, Okay, well, my pastor back in the day didn't smile and laugh. Man, let me tell you something. I guess we a new breed then.
Whole nother.
I'm a new breed because I love to have fun.
I would jank the life out
of me. One of my favorite things in the world to do is to make a person smile. Mm-hmm. Some people, when you reach them, they just so down in spirit. When you're reaching out to them, they so down in spirit. Sometimes what I do is I make them laugh before I share scripture with them. Why? I'm sharing the heart of Christ with them. Like Paul said, I become all things to all men so that I may win some.
That's all right.
So if you become all things to all men, then what if somebody need a smile? What if they ain't smiled in a while?
You know the thing, another thing, they don't think, they look at Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, and all that.
He's made when they can.
They look at all of them.
They're crying so loud in my ear, go ahead.
A good sour apple. They look at the disciples, and they don't realize that during the day of Jesus, they were really having fun with Jesus, too.
Yes.
But see, when they read the Bible, all they see is Jesus walking on water, casting out demons, healing the sick, healing the blind, and those are good things. But they don't see the time probably him, John, probably Jesus and Peter racing down the road or whatnot, foot racing. You know, they don't see them playing hide and seek or whatever. And so that's why I'm like this, that's why brother like that, because we have come to see another side of the Lord God that a lot of people haven't seen. It's not like that he haven't been his way. It's that you need to open up your heart to the Lord completely.
Right.
God is balanced. See, you may want to say people been looking at God like an unbalanced God. He always.
Yeah, like a one-dimensional.
Yeah, like one-dimensional.
Yeah,
like,
I get that.
Go to hell, be there. You going. You know, like, what?
Yeah.
So, be honest, that kind of attitude kind of had threw me off from the Bible a little bit. But I had to learn that, hey, just because it don't show me like that in there, that don't mean I'm not like that. So, I didn't read my Bible for 3 years, and I found out. I found God. I found Jesus to be really who he is outside of that, but his word was still in me, but for his characteristics, I didn't find it like in there because it didn't show it. I found him to be funny and to be loving, be laughing with my personal day-to-day talking with him.
And I'm glad you said that. You brought up a point about one time when I was going through some trouble, and I feel like, and you can take this how you want, sometimes when I'm having a heart-to-heart with God, he laughs at me. He laugh at me because that's how he teach me a lesson sometimes. Because for one, he talks to me in a way that fits my personality. You see what I'm saying? So I was in a depressed moment in my life one time, and I'm walking down the highway, walking away. What you laughing for?
Right, it's so funny. I got a story. Go ahead, I'm gonna tell you what happened.
Anyway, distracting me, but I'm walking down the highway, and I'm like, God, all this stuff going wrong. All this, man, I want to stay faithful to you. But, man, if you could just show me a glimpse of the future where all this stuff is better and fixed. God, and I'm just ranting and ranting, just running off at the mouth about what I want God to do to show me. Like, God, show me a glimpse of this getting better. And then, I'll be strong and have faith in you and keep pushing on. And God started laughing like, bro, that ain't faith. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you talking about show you a picture so you can see it, and then you'll have faith. That's not faith. And it's like when he told me that, he was laughing. It's like he bust out laughing when I said it. Like, come on, son. Come on, dad. You already know this. Listen to yourself. You know what I'm saying? So that's how God responded to me sometimes. You know?
I ain't live. This is fun. I was outside. Similar situation.
Mm-hmm.
I was on my knees. I was like, God, man, what I do to you, man? And I was like, why you didn't want to come through to me? Bro, I literally said, you want me to eat this dirt or something? You want me to eat this grass, man? I eat the grass. He was like, I literally heard him like, man, you is crazy. I was like, why is this going on? Like, I'm looking at it like, do I need to humble myself some more, eat some grass or something? Bro, I literally heard him like, man,
you know what? Crazy. Every time we're having a good conversation, man, and we going in a great direction, we laughing and giving good word and encouragement and edification. Then that man come with some foolishness, man.
Man, but that's the truth, though.
Why would you ask God, you want me to eat some dirt?
Because, eat some grass. Bro, I was
you
like.
You should have said, yeah, go ahead.
You know, you looking like you got to do something for God to move or something. I was like, man, yeah. God, what? You want me to lay on the ground? I was just doing all this stuff. He was like, man, this man lost it. You know? When I got up, I'm like, man, what freak? But the main thing about to say is this, though.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus the Christ did not make you. So you will live on earth. I understand we go through stuff.
We know.
But he did not make you. So every day, you will be mad, complaining. He didn't make you to be mad and complaining fussing every day. Yes, we have trials. Right. We know that. But you need to know that Jesus Christ is a big, big, big kid. He is also God, but he knows the heart of a child.
Mm-hmm.
He knows the heart of an adult.
Mm-hmm.
He knows that he's a fun God. He very down to earth. And since a lot of y'all following these preachers because y'all feel more confident. Like he said, y'all think their relationship is more serious with God because they don't smile. Because they afraid when they see. That's why a lot of people say, they used to tell me that, I can't take that man serious. They used to tell me that a lot. Mm-hmm. I can't take him serious because I was laughing and smiling. They were scared I was on something. A lot of folks said, man, what kind of spirit on you? A lot of folks say that. What spirit you of?
Mm.
The Holy Spirit.
There you go.
See, the Holy Spirit is whole. He's full.
And I was just about to say that a lot of people operate like that because they don't have the fullness of the Holy Spirit.
Nope.
Because like we were saying earlier, God, Jesus, the Holy Spirit is not one dimensional. There are many different facets of the Trinity or God that a lot of people just don't tap into. Like, if God can be caring, compassionate, understanding, faithful, loving, why he can't be funny?
Then
why he can't smile sometimes?
Right.
Like if he has all these different moods and personalities, if he can be angry, he can be happy.
Oh.
Come on.
Hey man, don't you own a church?
Don't I own a church?
Listen, y'all know brother here is a pastor, right? Like brother's a pastor. Yeah. Bro literally have the have a facility where he can throw sermons at. Bro can preach. Like bro really can read. Bro be understanding. He explains stuff that when I can't explain. But that's the truth. How can we sit here and say God can be angry, but he can't laugh?
Exactly.
How?
Mm-hmm.
Like you said, he just one dimensional. He just one sided. Mm-hmm. Oh, but you say, oh my God, is everything? He can't be everything to you if you send.
I'm saying you lying to yourself.
Yeah, you lying to your doggone self. Listen,
what they call it, a contradiction.
You contradicting yourself.
God can be everything, but he can't smile.
Listen, I get it, y'all. You're scared. You think somebody gonna lead you to hell? They joking around. Listen, If I lead anybody to hell, it be myself. When I ain't going, I'm just saying I ain't gonna lead y'all to hell. That's basically what I'm saying. In other words, what I meant is that I take the Lord, I know the Lord, and if anything, I mess myself before I mess up y'all, and I ain't about to mess myself up. That's all I was trying to say. You know? So yeah, man, Jesus, God is a down to earth God. He a real down to earth God. He real cool. He real funny. He real loving. Y'all just got to tap into it. Y'all got to get out of that religion religion type mindset that everything's so serious, everything just so stern and strict, mm-hmm. and all of that. You got to come up out of that. See here.
Wow.
In the world of me in pain.
Yes,
we do our thing now.
Sometimes.
Without no change.
Say that now.
You got some change.
I need a dime.
Because everything ain't the same.
It's not a crime.
Watch how it rain.
Over time.
Feel a vein. But anyway.
Down my spine. I don't know.
So anyway. Yeah, man.
Hello, listen, I had a scripture I wanted to bring up. It's just Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. There is a time for everything and yes. a season for every activity under the heavens. Now, I'm not going to read the rest of it, but it says a time to be born, time to die, a time to heal, time to tear down, time to build up, time to uproot. You know, just a time to mourn. What did it say to him? Verse 4. Is a time to weep and a time to laugh. Hmm. God has appointed a time for everything. Everything. Now, this is what we don't want to get y'all, want to mess y'all up in. There are times when me and him sit down and talk, and it's a 100% legitimate, serious conversation because that's what the time calls for. That's what the situation calls for.
Of course.
But sometimes, even like, there'll be some times where I'm not feeling as good. Where like something going on in my life and I'll be around him and he'll just say the intentionally, now he ain't stupid by far, but he'll just say the dumbest thing on earth. And I'll be like, bro, I'm trying to be in my feelings right now. Why are you saying some things like that? But it what it does is that's ministry. Because what it does is it takes me out of that mood for a while. It takes me away from that and get me to, you know what? Things not so bad. I can smile, even in the midst of all this pain. You know what I'm saying? So it's the time for everything. You just gotta, you know, have discernment.
See, if you sad, this is what you need to do. If you are sad, don't be. If you are mad, don't be.
That man owns something.
You feel me?
Man
owns
something. Yeah.
If you depressed, don't be.
If you depressed, then get impressed. Did that go?
If you don't know what you're saying, don't say it. No, but man.
I tried it.
But man, listen. The Lord Jesus, man. Y'all. If y'all want to follow people that, you know, that's serious and always looking like, man, demons in your house.
Mm-hmm.
And you need to remove these items. Oh, hell, it's about to be hot. Oh, I feel demons coming through the roof. Everything demons.
You need to move.
Bro, I know a couple folks on YouTube be like that all the time, bro. Listen, I know I gave out some hell vision to the Lord. I have to when God showed me. But every video.
But see, like you say, it's a time for that.
It's a time. But every video, cuz, ain't by no demons, bro. Listen, you giving demons power every time you bring their name up. The Bible said he inhabits praise. So every time I speak about Jesus, I'm giving praise to him. So he calmed down.
But praise is something happy.
Praise is something good.
It's something joyful.
Wonderful.
You don't praise like this. Thank you, God.
Some people do.
How?
They crazy.
What?
They don't have no relationship. How you praising God? You think they praising God like that in heaven?
Mm-hmm. When I praise and when I worship, I'm like, thank you, Lord. Man, sometimes like it gets so deep for me. I be like, God come through for me in a major way. I'd be like, God, look at what you did. I told you was going to do it, Lord. I told him he was going to do it. When I pray, I'm like, God, I know that you're capable and able to do this, and I know that you're going to do it. Okay, now don't play with me. You joke. See, that's the problem. That's why you're not a real man of God. You joke too much. You play too much, man. I can't take you serious.
You can't take me serious.
Where we going to hell then?
No, you stop putting me in that boat.
Oh, okay then.
Do not put me in that boat.
No, doc. Oh, no, sir.
Hey, look, I say we're going ahead. They say, oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? Oh,
look. When did you start speaking French?
The crowd like that crap. Oh, we're going to hell. They love that hell stuff. Uh-oh. Oh, heck no, nah, I'm just joking. Anyway, listen. We love you, man. Look, just know Jesus is way more down to earth than we are.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, he gave me a revelation that, man, you was a channel man to be balanced.
Mm.
Sin leads to hell. Mm. You can be forgiven, but you gotta, you know, go to Jesus about it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we can get into all that. There's a place called heaven. There is joy. There is pain. There is a time to be serious. There's a time to not be serious. There's a time to joke around. Sometimes we may get on here, may not have nothing to talk about, and the Lord may say, man, just have fun on them. There is a time. Don't be consumed in death, demons, and hell, and woe, and glow, and the mark of the beast. Because this is one thing about it, pain. And we're going to cut this out, because in 20 minutes, we're going to do our job.
There you go.
That Jesus tell us to do.
That's it.
When Jesus come back, we're going to be found doing our job.
Exactly.
So we ain't worried about getting left behind. If you worried about getting left behind, something is wrong.
That means you ain't focused on the work.
They ain't focused on the work. So focus on Jesus. Focus on what you have to do. And hey, man, I am Mac Praise.
And I'm that man, his pain.
And until next time.